Hello my friends, it's the Game Boy Geek here, and today we find ourselves in a world of letters and words, but there are no vowels to be found. You'll be racing against both time and each other to recognize words that have had their vowels removed. Vowel is the game of letters gone astray for 2 to 5 players, plays in 30 to 40 minutes for ages 14 and up, and published by Cameron Art Games. It's on Kickstarter right now, so I'm going to show you how the game works, and I'll see you on the other side. This is a Kickstarter preview, so all the art and components you see here are prototype. They're not final. If you'd like to see all the final art and components, click the link below that will bring you directly to the Kickstarter project page. In Vowl, you're going to be under a timer, and you're going to be trying to come up with a word that has missing vowels. So here it has M, N, and Y. The M is always the first letter in the word, but then in between these, there's going to be vowels, one in between each of them, and there may be a vowel on the end. Now in this game, Y is not a vowel. So if you were trying to come up with a word here, you might say money, for example. Now you could not say many because then there's no vowel between the N and the Y. And it is possible for some cards to have multiple correct answers. Now the game has different types of cards, basic, advanced, and experts. We'll go over these advanced and expert ones a little bit later. On your turn, you're going to roll these two dice. It's going to tell you how many vowel cards you're going to take from the basic deck, and it's going to tell you the game mode. This one means solo. You're going to be playing on your own. Now in the basic game, you're actually going to have a 25 second sand timer, but today I'm just using a digital timer for you. So at the beginning of the game, each player is just going to take this many. So in this case, we would draw 4 cards, we would not look at them yet, and we'd put them in a stack in front of us face down. So once you have your stack, you'll flip the sand timer in your case, and you would start this and you flip them over. You're trying to get all these done. And in this case, again, you're trying to place a vowel in between each of these consonants, and there may be one in the end, and again, there may be more than one solution. And if once you get it right, you'll just flip the next one over and you'll continue. You're trying to get through this stack before this time runs out. If you want to, you can pass, place this face down off to the side, keep going, and you can come back to this one when you've completed the other cards. So let's try this for real. You can play along with me. So this one, maybe we have medic. Limit, layer, and this last one, 5 seconds, melon. Now I've finished with 2 seconds left. Now here's the scoreboard, and each player is going to get a scoring token. They're each going to be a different vowel and a color. Now let's just say we were I in purple. Now we successfully completed this round. So you have two choices. You can either move your scoring token 2, and this is important because on all future rounds, not only will you be taking the amount of green-backed cards based upon this die, now most of the time it's 4, but it might be 5, and it might be 3. You're always going to take that many like we just did, but in addition to that, you're always going to take a certain amount of cards depending on where your scoring token is. So next round, if we had rolled this, we would take 3 basic cards, the green ones, and 2 more. But if we were here, we would take the 3 basic green cards, and we would get 1 yellow, which is one of the advanced ones. But if we're here, we would have to take one of the expert ones in addition to this. So depending on where you are, you'll have to take additional cards in your future turns. Now I fast forward a little bit into the game because instead of taking your 2 points on a successful round and moving your scoring marker 2 to the right, you can instead move it 1, just like this. But you also must move your victory token 1 to the left. And you must do this for 1 other opponent of your choosing. And this is important because now I would have been here, which was a red and a yellow, you know, expert and advanced. But now next round, I have to take 2 advanced. So it's going to be a little bit easier for me to do that and have a successful round. So in this case, I might just want to go 1. It's also going to bring this back. And this is important because when these 2 tokens, my scoring and my victory, either get on top of each other or you pass them in a round, that's how you win the game. And conversely, bringing an opponent's down is going to make it harder for them possibly or give them different challenges. For example, they would have had 2 greens and a red, and now they're getting a yellow and a red, and that might be harder for them. But it also means that opponent is 1 step closer to victory. And another reason you'd want to do this is because if you're able to bring your victory token down, this means, again, since when you match your two tokens, you win the game, this means that this token isn't going to have to go through these harder rounds towards the end of the game. So there's some strategy as to how to take your points. Now, after you're done with your turn, it just goes clockwise. And let's say that next player is the yellow player with the A there. So they're going to take the amount of basic cards on the die plus one yellow one. Now, in this case, this player rolled the three, but also rolled this. And this is essentially partner play. You're going to pick any partner to actually work with you. So in addition to the three basic cards, you're also going to take three more of those green basic cards as shown in this die, and you're gonna place them with those. So now there's a total of six there. Now, we already showed you that they're on the board and they have to take an advanced yellow card too. They can decide to put this on top or below all the other cards. Of course, remembering that you can never look at the backs of any of these. Now, since your partner has to be seated to your immediate left or right, you'll place these cards directly in between you because you're both gonna be doing this simultaneously. So once they're there, you would start the timer as normal and then you would begin. And at this point, either player can say a word that makes sense. And if it is, then you just flip the next one and you keep going through. You're trying to get through this entire pile to have a successful round. Now, if you're successful, both players will be able to score, but it starts with the player whose round and turn it was first because they might manipulate some of these other ones and that might change what the next player will do. And again, after that turn, it goes to the next player's turn clockwise. Now, if you ever roll this, this is a head-to-head matchup. You're going to select any other player to go head-to-head. You're each going to have your own deck of cards. And for example, you're always going to get the amount of basic cards on the die as normal, but each player is going to get the additional cards depending on where their scoring marker is. For example, we'll get two yellows, and the player that we've chosen, in this case, the A, is going to get one yellow. And that means there's some strategy as to which player you choose depending on which cards that you know that they're going to have to draw. Then you'd start the timer as normal and both players are going through their own deck trying to be the first to get through all of it. Now if the timer runs out and neither player got through them all, then whoever has gotten through more cards is successful. If they're tied, you take the top red expert deck card, flip it over, and the first one between both of them that gets this correct will be the successful. And that's pretty much how you play. Remember, you win by getting your scoring token on or past your victory token. The first one to do this wins. And if more than one player does this in the same round, you have a head-to-head draw just like we just showed you. Now, when playing with two players, if you roll the partner mode, in this case, it's going to be selection mode. One of the other players is going to take all of these, so four basic cards plus three, so seven of them. They're going to secretly look at these and discard three of them out of the round. So in this case, there's a total of four cards here, but the players whose turn it is still has to draw the additional cards based upon where they are on the score track, in this case, one expert card. Now, if you succeed, you score as normal. For an added challenge, you can increase the difficulty by having a longer score track and having the timer only be 15 seconds long. And just to show you the different types of cards, here are six basic cards. If you like, you can pause the video now and try to come up with words on your own. And here are six of the yellow advanced type cards. Go ahead and pause it and try it for yourself. And finally, here are six of the red expert cards. Pause here and have some fun trying to figure these out. Well, there you have Vowl, and as I showed in the overview, it's an easy to learn game for the whole family, and you can alter the difficulty when playing against less experienced players or children. If you'd like to see the final art and components and all the different pledge levels available, you can click the link below me in the description of this video, and it will take you directly to the Kickstarter project page, and I'm sure the fine folks at Cameron Art Games would love your support.